Ladies and gentlemen, Main Events and Pushka Promotions present live from the beautiful Turning Stone Resort Casino in Verona, New York, NBC Sports Fight Night in the afternoon. Today's bouts are sanctioned by the Oneida Indian Nation Athletic Commission, Executive Director Dan Gustafson. Our commissioners, Bill Fournier, Art Pierce, our Chief Inspector, Bill Rossi, and our timekeeper at the bell, Bob Keiko. Boxing fans, here we go. Six rounds of action in the cruiserweight division. Our judges, Wynn Kintz, John McKay, and Tom Schreck, and our referee, Charlie Fitch. Introducing first, fighting out of the blue corner. He comes to us tonight from Houston, Texas. He weighed in at 200 pounds, white trunks, black trim, a perfect professional record, 9 victories, no defeats. 4 of his wins coming by way of knockout. Please welcome Qantas, the Grim Reaper Graves. And his opponent fighting out of the red corner. He comes to us this evening from Albania. He also weighed in at 200 pounds, red trunks, white trim. Professional record, 9 victories, 2 defeats, 2 draws, 8 of his 9 victories coming by way of knockout. Please welcome Seb Dial, the Alarian Sharifi. Our referee, Charlie Fitch, has our fighters' final instructions.
Good evening, gentlemen. You both know the rules. Make it a clean fight. Touch gloves now. Come on, fighting at the bell.
6 rounds, cruiserweights.
Round 1 underway. Seb Dial Sharifi in the red trunks. Of those 8 career knockouts, 6 have come in the first 3 rounds. Combination early for Sharifi.
Yeah, good right hand by Sharifi. You know, you see Graves coming out and
trying
to stab that jab at the body, establish that. Taller fighter, a lot of times like to use that punch, and comes right out with it.
Come on, work out of there. Break!
What's interesting is Graves got that very good amateur background. He was rated number 2 in the United States, fought Deontay Wilder a couple different times, who, you know, is an undefeated heavyweight, now rated in the top 10 in the world, and, you know, that experience will all serve him very well in the professional ranks.
Graves, an alternate at heavyweight on the 2008 Olympic team. And as you mentioned, that great amateur career he had, Sharifi from Albania, 36-4 as an amateur.
You tell both guys know how to fight. You know, Sharifi came out, he shot a good right hand whenever Graves was trying to shoot the jabs, and you know, got Graves' attention, and you know, Graves back to the game plan. More jabs up and down, more good punches, and you know, both guys got some ability. In this first round, Kenny, it's always more of a feeling out process, and you know, whoever will get started with his jab first and look to set that up can start to set up more combinations more quickly. So we'll see who gets off to the good start with a good jab.
Break!
And he break again.
The crowd was laughing because Sharifi hit him from behind. He did the wrap around the back to punch, caught him good.
Break!
The sneak one in.
They did. A lot of fighters do that sometimes. Pretty even first round so far, Ken.
As you mentioned, BJ, it's still the get acquainted stage. Much respect for both these guys. Graves 9-0 in the white trunks, trying to stay undefeated. Off to a very good pro start, 4 knockouts in his career, 31-year-old.
Nice counter left hook by Graves. Sharifi kind of pushing in with the jab a little bit. Graves stepped back and caught him with a nice counter left hook, got the attention of Sharifi. You see Graves is tall, but he doesn't really fight like a tall fighter. You see him kind of crouching down there. He's looking to counterpunch Sharifi and take advantage of those mistakes.
Final seconds, round one. Graves Sharifi. Evenly matched so far.
Good shot at the end of the round by Graves. Whenever we get a second.
Pedrina, huh? Okay. Du machst das mit Aussehen, lass den Körper schaffen. Huh? Er ist gross, aber er hat nicht so viel Power. Also komm du mit dem Power. Tak, tak, pam, tak, tak, pam. Ist gut? Warte, warte. Ja? Du musst mal schauen. Okay.
We get ready for round two, scheduled for six between cruiserweights. Sharifi in the red, Graves in the white. Graves coming in here, a 9-0 record. Sharifi, 9-2-2.
Break!
Rather
break.
Evenly matched first round. Larry Hazard with us as always, scoring the bout. How about that first round, Larry?
Break!
Graves 10-9. Graves did some nice work later on and made adjustments in a very much get-acquainted first round, BJ.
Yeah, it did. It was very even through the first part of the round. Sharifi landed some nice right hands, but Graves came on down the stretch and landed some good combinations. A little sharper punch down Graves. Gave him a round.
Combo for Graves. Graves with a nice, solid jab.
Break!
One thing Graves needs to be careful of, whenever Sharifi shoots that double jab in the right hand, Graves has to be careful not to just lean and stay on his right side. Leaves him open for that right hand. So I've seen Sharifi try to do it a couple times, and he's getting a little closer. So you see him leaning over to the right hand side, Sharifi caught him with a nice right hand. He's got to be careful to keep his head off the center, keep it off the right side as well.
Good shots by Sharifi.
Nice counter right hand by Graves. And that's not a move you see from a lot of big guys. You see it from some of the, the welterweight, the lightweight guys. But to have the speed and agility to pull that off, that shows a lot of athleticism by Graves.
A solid right, and you can see some swelling now under the left eye of Sharifi. A welt popping out with that last punch.
Doesn't take much, Kenny. See a little blood from the nose of Graves, too, so this fight's starting to pick up a little bit.
A fight expected to be evenly matched, BJ. So far it is.
Yeah, it's been pretty close. And this is a good experience for Graves. He's 9-0 with four knockouts. How many times has he been in the second round and had blood coming out of his nose? So everything's a learning experience when you're here, and both guys look like they're looking to make the most of it.
And Sharifi, as we mentioned earlier, he is a guy that has finished most of his fights quickly. Six of his victories coming in the first three rounds by way of knockout.
So it'll be interesting to see how Sharifi responds whenever he's in rounds four, five, and six. A lot of guys who score early knockouts, don't really handle the later rounds too well. So it'll be interesting to see. Good work inside by Sharifi. Sharifi's come out a lot better in the second round, kid. Putting his punches together better, more combinations on the inside. Nice jab by Graves.
Sharifi again doing his work inside. Uppercut, nice uppercut by Quantas Graves.
He got his attention, and the beauty of the uppercut is it sets up the left hook. So Graves needs to make sure and put that left hook behind that uppercut next time and take advantage of a very nice punch that he landed a second ago. Good round by Sharifi, though.
Break!
Round two, this one's scheduled for six as round two draws to an end.
Time!
Enough, man. Okay. You're spending too much time going back, okay? We don't want to do that.
Put me the bucket in the center between the legs.
Yeah. We're 1-1.
I have a one round each.
Sharifi.
Okay, Noch nicht abschließen. Jetzt gibst du mir alles. Okay, baby. Body, pam, champ. Huh? Was du vorher gemacht hast? Body, auf die Seite laufen, bam, check! Raus, bang, hocken. Lass ihn jetzt nicht entkommen.
The corner of Sevdi Al Sharifi as we take a look at round two action, BJ.
Yeah, good jab by Graves.
On the inside.
Once again, you know, you see Graves, whenever Sharifi's shooting that right hand, kind of leaning to his right, he's got to be careful to stay out of range right there. He's evading those punches, but, you know, Sharifi was getting closer in the last round.
Quintus Graves in the white trunks coming in here 9-0 as we start round three, cruiserweight scheduled for six.
And this is a very interesting round, Kenny, because Graves won the first round, Sharifi won the second round, so who's going to come out here in this third round and take control of this fight?
Larry Hazard scoring the second round 10-9 for Sharifi, and Graves getting the first round, living up to the billing as a close fight between two up-and-comers in the cruiserweight ranks.
Sharifi's doing some good work in the beginning of this third round. I would like to see Graves not just put his hands up so high. Whenever you put yourself, your hands that high, sometimes you can handcuff yourself. You're not in position to counter, so look to move your head a little more. Look to land the counter shot so Sharifi can't be quite so bold.
Out of there. Don't hold each other. All right, break!
Get back. And quickly, you can hear Graves' corner saying, get back in it. And he tries to.
Yeah, his corner actually told him, get back on the jab. And, you know, the reason why that's important is because both guys are now in the middle stages of the fight. They're looking just to get in there and land big punches. If they will start with the jab, they will have a much higher success rate. Graves is the taller fighter. He's got the sharper jab. He needs to use it here because he doesn't want to get lured into an inside fight with Sharifi. Right there is where he needs to be definitely utilizing his jab. It's not that Graves doesn't have good inside punches. He does. He's a pretty compact fighter there on the inside. He can make things a lot easier on himself with the use of that left jab. Nice double left hook by Graves. So both guys on the inside here, Kenny, you're fighting for position. Both guys' heads are kind of in the middle. Got to be careful for headbutts here. But, you know, if Graves will get his head off to one side or step over to one side and create a different angle to create offense for himself, he could be successful. Same thing with Sharifi. Good uppercut by Sharifi.
And Sharifi sliding in that uppercut. Sharifi seemingly is getting stronger in this fight.
It got a little momentum, but Graves landed some good punches in the beginning of this round. Sharifi did as well. You know, this last 50 seconds of the round could determine the winner. Once again, you see Graves leading in with a lead left hook. Never well advised. You want to make sure you use that jab first. And looks like Graves might be getting a little tired here. So Sharifi, if he could step that pressure up, we might see more evidence of that.
Good combinations by Sharifi.
Good right uppercut by Graves. Once again, the left hook after that right uppercut, I was always taught, is the cleanup punch there. You only shoot that right uppercut to land that left hook afterwards, and Graves has to take advantage of landing that very nice punch. There he goes. See Graves starting to move his feet a little there. That way he can create more offensive position for himself. When they're both standing in front of one another, it's hard for either fighter to have the advantage.
Blood coming out of the nose of Graves as round three of these cruiserweights getting ready to come to an end.
Halfway there, we start that water. Yeah. Start putting your punches together. Take a deep breath.
Here.
Doing fine.
Vergiss deinen Niveau für zwei. Vergiss deinen Niveau für zwei. Noch am Schlag.
Okay. Sorry.
Warte. Noch am Schlag. Okay. Sofort den Punkt. Vaseline.
Quintus Graves trying to stay unbeaten. A 9-0 record coming into this. As you see action from the last round, the third.
And he set it up nicely, Kenny, with that right hook to the body first. That made Sharifi bring his elbows back. And then he came with a nice straight right hand right afterwards. Good setup punch, good combination. You know, Sharifi also had a lot of good moments in that last round. And he feels it. You can see him jumping out of the corner. He's excited.
Break!
The start of this fourth round. He's trying to apply pressure to see more evidence of if Graves is going to wilt or not in the last two rounds.
Sevdi Al Sharifi in the red trunks. We're in round four, it's scheduled for six.
And it's very important right here. Sharifi might be taking momentum of the fight here. You know, I had him up the last round and the second round. Graves won the first round. But it's very important that Graves can come out and make a statement in this fourth round because there's only six rounds, Kenny.
Larry scoring that last one for Sharifi,
yeah.
10-9. So he has him up two rounds to one.
Break.
And I agree with Larry. I think Sharif did better work in that last round. He's trying to make the fight. You know, Graves still landed some good shots, but it looks like he might be getting a little fatigued and, you know. Sharif is landing some good punches.
That was a rough punch by Sharif, one of his strongest.
Once again here, you know, Graves, it seems like he has the edge in speed. He's got the edge in height, maybe a little bit in athleticism, but without the use of that left jab, it makes it a very even fight. Sharif, he's walking right in, and he's able to use his physical strength to move Graves around. Graves is a sharp puncher, but he's not a huge puncher, so he's got to make sure that he's smart in this fourth, fifth, and sixth round. Sharif is starting to have an edge on my scorecard.
And Sharif doing nice work inside in this fight.
Break. He is. He's not doing anything spectacular, Kenny, but he's letting his hands go, and he seems like the more assertive fighter, which has earned him the last two rounds.
Graves' corner encouraging him. We overheard between rounds, let your hands go more, get more active, get more busy, talking about that aggressive level that you speak of.
Yeah, and it's important here with both guys, you know, like I said, we're in the middle stages of the fight. You know, both guys got to really show and assert themselves to show these judges that they want to win this fight. There's only six rounds to work with, so on an even-paced fight like this, a lot of times the guy showing effective aggression and the clean punching, you know, is going to get all these middle rounds. See, that's a nice move by Sharif. You see his head up with Graves. He tried to just take a step over to the side and land that left hook. That's how he can be effective. Good use of the jab by Sharif.
Stop punching.
Now right here when the referee breaks is where Graves needs to stick that left jab back in Sharifi's face instead of coming with that lead left hook.
Look over the arm.
Once he starts connecting with the jab, Kenny, then he can shoot that jab, then the hook, or then he can shoot the lead hook. But he's got to make solid contact with the jab first to keep Sharifi thinking.
Sharifi with that crafty move, holding a little longer onto the arms of Graves when they separated just a minute ago as we come to the final seconds now of round four. In a very close fight, Sharifi and Graves.
Time!
To out hustle this guy from now on, man. You're ice waiting bag. Inside.
Ice bag.
You're waiting too long for this guy, man, okay?
Man.
Don't
you
just listen.
You gotta do something. You're gonna lose your fight. You need to kick his ass right now, both rounds.
Well, you need to, yeah.
You better go. I'm not bullshitting. You're gonna have to go right now.
Hey, but then, hold that in your condition. Give him mal ein, zwei Hit. No, it's good.
Ist gut.
Ist gut? Wasser. Water, water.
Water.
Okay. Okay, baby.
Seconds down!
Sevdiel Sharifi in the red trunks, Qantas Graves the white. We begin round five, cruiserweight scheduled for six in what has been a very close fight.
No punches.
Yeah, it has. It's been a close fight, and he's got two rounds to go.
That's not okay.
Graves, and I feel like he needs you know, both of these last two rounds to get the decision. Good body shot by Graves. You see, this is the type of fight he needs to fight right here. Use that left jab, stab it up, stab it down, use the right hand of the body, and make Sharifi think before walking in instead of just allowing him to come in and bully him around.
Count your box, you can see Sharifi in that last round. The punch is thrown and landed compared to that of Graves, and in Graves' corner, they were again emphasizing you've got to get busy in this fight. You've got to get more aggressive.
He's doing good. It's not necessarily that he has to, you know, walk towards Sharifi and push Sharifi around. He just needs to fight a little more assertive. You see him now. He's over his feet better. He's asserting his balance. He's using his left jab. And Sharifi's a lot more cautious to come in because Graves is making him pay a little bit when he does.
It's a jab that's been absent since almost the first round.
Yeah, it has. He came out and he used it a couple times in the beginning and put it away. And Sharifi took all those middle rounds.
In that last round, Larry has Sharifi again First round to Graves. Break. It's been Sharifi since in this close fight.
And one thing I'd like to see Graves do is shoot a nice counter punch whenever Sharifi shoots that right hand. He's allowing Sharifi to walk in with the jab in the right hand. He's just slipping out of the way. If he were to counter him with a nice shot, a hook, or another right hand after that punch, that would make Sharifi think twice before shooting whatever he feels like. Because when you know there's no consequence to shoot a punch, you're going to keep shooting it. You see Graves once again leaning to the right side after Sharifi shoots the jab. It leaves him right in line with that right hand. Very dangerous, but he's gotten away with it so far.
Graves has won four fights by way of knockout. None of them, though, passed the fourth round.
Break!
And you see Graves, he's a sharp puncher, but he's not a knockout artist, but he's definitely a sharp puncher. But what he's got to do here is get back to his jab, keep control of this round,
break!
And give him some momentum going into the sixth round. Sharifi's having problems landing punches this round. Beautiful punches by Graves right there.
Good combinations by Graves, some of his best in this fight.
The jab and the head movement set it all up, Ken. The jab and the head movement. It's given Sharifi just enough hesitation to where Graves can get off, and Graves had a much better round here in the fifth. Might get him back in this fight. Both fighters there in the middle. Be careful to keep their head off the center when you get position. Punch by Graves again.
Nice right by Graves. Graves again. This is Graves'
strongest 10 seconds
round
to the bell.
Since the first. He is reasserting himself here in the fifth round.
They did have a very good round, and you know, I got a few rounds to tune in for.
So ten!
Graves bouncing back.
Just like you. That
his round was good.
Yeah. But we need this one big, Graves.
One more water bottle.
Water.
Got it.
How come?
No.
Verstehst? Wenn es einfach reduzierst, dann kommt der, hä? Wie fühlst du dich?
Ja, ein bisschen.
Ja, noch ein bisschen, a little bit.
Last round, right?
Thank you. Oh, yeah. Du gehst da schon nach unten, ich hätte okay?
You need this round bad, buddy. You've got to take over. That was a great round for you, but you started too slow. You get this round big.
Water.
Undefeated Qantas Graves, 9-0, with his strongest Second round down. In the fifth. And here he goes to work.
We're going to touch gloves last round. We're going to touch gloves.
Terrific right there. BJ, he rediscovered his jab, got back in rhythm. Now we go to the sixth and final round. Larry Hazard scoring that last round, 10-9 for Graves.
You had the same score. I don't think there's any dispute on who won the fifth round. Graves came out, used his jab, used some very nice head movement to set up some offense. And, you know, it was a very good round.
So our unofficial scoring is 3-2 for Sharifi.
Yeah, there's a chance that, you know, one of those middle rounds could have went to Graves, but, you know, I had all three of them for Sharifi, so did Larry. So, you know, the most sure thing is Graves needs this round to pull out a draw.
And look at the dramatic change for Qantas Graves, who landed three times the power punches in that last round than in previous round.
Good hook right hand from Graves there.
Napoleon.
That's something I would have liked to see from him from the beginning. That hook right hand, not just the simple lead hook, because he kept missing the hook. The right hand behind it made it makes that combination very dangerous. Another good punch by Graves.
And a good right in there by Graves as well.
And you like to see Graves, you know, closing the fight and finishing the fight like he is. You know, he lost the second, third, and fourth round possibly. He comes back in the fifth, he has a great fifth round. Now in the sixth, he's asserting himself again and showing that he really wants to win this fight. That's what you like to see out of a young prospect.
Two good young prospects, 25-year-old Sharifi, 31-year-old Graves. Sharifi has given him a tough test today. Sharifi trying to get busy inside again where he has been steady and true throughout this fight when he's been able to get inside.
He's having trouble landing in this round though, Kenny. Graves has landed the cleaner punches in this round. You know, Sharifi's still got more energy, but he needs to take advantage of that. Get inside, touch Graves with the jabs, touch him to the body, and make it clear to the judges that you know, he's landing the better punches in this round. good left hook.
Great, great punches.
And you see, you know, Sharif, he's trying to come in. He's trying to do the things he did in the middle rounds, but Graves is making it a little more difficult with the use of that left jab and a little more head movement. Still, you see Graves fatigued here. Definitely one thing you want to stay away from. Good comp, good punch by Graves.
Look out of here. Let your hands go and move out of here.
Graves, this is the third time in his career that he has been to the sixth round. He has
Graves. Beautiful counter punches there.
Graves has thrown some of his best punches in these last two rounds.
Yeah, he has. You know, he's landed the cleaner punches in this round. And, you know, Sharifi might have more energy.
5 seconds in the fight.
Graves with the better pedigree is making Sharifi pay in this final round, too.
He's even sliding in another left. Graves in that exchange on the ropes.
Good first fight.
He comes to an end. Graves and Sharifi going the distance. The judges will make the call in a very close fight.
Here, this is not your blood. This is not your blood.
Zev Dayo, Sharifi coming in here 9-2-2.
We're going to clear the ring right now.
And Qantas Graves, a perfect 9-0.
Pictures, Jimbo. Pictures.
A fight early on that Graves looked strong. Sharifi in the middle rounds. Graves closed out with two very strong rounds. And Graves rediscovered the jab and got right back in this in the fourth round. Fourth, fifth rounds, especially the fifth and sixth round.
Yeah, he did, and Graves definitely landed the cleaner, harder punches. But, you know, you score a professional fight on a 10-point must system. You know, the middle rounds, you got to give them to Sharifi. You know, definitely the third and the fourth, maybe the second as well. It's very possible that Graves wins this 4-2, but on my scorecard, I had it 3-3. So, but you know, judging in boxing, you never know what's going to, what the final verdict's going to be.
And Larry as well had it 3 rounds. A piece with Graves taking those last two rounds. And you look in Graves' corner, great amateur career, perfect as a pro so far. Sharifi from Albania. Amateur credentials, not that of Graves, but he's had a strong pro start, 9-2-2. Been a very busy fighter for this 25-year-old. In only his fourth year as a pro. He believes he's won it. I'm sure Graves' corner believes they've won it.
I think Graves' corner is a little more realistic. I think Sharifi's corner feels like, you know, he fought well, but.
Joe Antonacci has the results.
How you doing, man?
Boxing fans, after 6 rounds of nonstop action, we go to the judges' scorecards. Judge John McKay scores the bout 58-56 for Graves, while judges Tom Schreck and Wynn Kintz both score the bout 57-57 even. We have a majority draw. How about a round of applause for both of these fighters?
Indicative of the close fight throughout. Sharifi and Graves fight to a draw.
It was, and you know, Graves is going to learn from this. He got a little lethargic in the middle rounds. He definitely was the better fighter, but Sharifi outworked him in those middle rounds. And, you know, on my scorecard, the draw was the just verdict.